Just left. So we wrote her a song to say goodbye. her daughter, who was probably 5 or 4 when she started, one time we were driving over the bridge, and she said, "Oh, Mom, that's the river you work for." Couldn't pass that one up. It's called the Sunderland Bridge Soft Shoe. Or... the Sunderland Bridge Soft Shoe. It's sort of new, so.
Wherever you may be tonight, rest easy, my Lord. wishes to have again. Dances you did then, when you were on your feet, you never missed a thing, my friend. You're in my thoughts once more, it happens again and again. Your mom will take the floor and dance till the night would end. However, so it's never seen to rest, you just depend for more.
So just prepare yourself. He might come out perfectly, but you never know.
Brooks Wilson. Maybe 10 years ago, we had lots of friends who said, hey, you've got to come. And we'll all come out together and we'll play all weekend. So we did that for a while. That's what we burned out, I think. And I'm just bluegrass. One of the last ones we went to was up at the Tunbridge Fairgrounds up in northern Vermont. Traditional songs over and over again. And since we're songwriters, usually we get the, you can't play that song in our campsite because it has too many chord things. So we said, well, you know, so we got a nice camping site over by the river. We found up there next to the fairgrounds. And we wrote a song kind of about the whole scene.
Talking round.
the Quakers since the mid-80s, because that's when Paul first moved here. And I can remember the very first party he had here. Lucky I can remember.
I can.
All right, this song called Killing the Zero.
Thank you.
This is a song that's been around for ages and ages, and people have done different versions of it. And when I first heard it, I heard it on the banjo, and I just went, ah! I want to play stuff like that. I want to play that kind of modal sounding song. So this banjo has been with me a long time. It's going to be at least 130 years old now, probably older than that. Not that I'm that old. Is here everything okay?
Yeah.
As he goes on by.
a song. Mary sings with me on my latest CD, and I asked her to sing a couple songs with us tonight, and she's going to find a microphone somewhere.
Maybe that one.
Rainbow.
just going to do one more quick song and take a nice break and get a chance to peruse out there. I know Pat Dex brought some really wonderful stuff to look at, and Mark also brought things. And I just want to put a plug in for Anand. If you go to Ronnie Arbo and Daisy Mahan's website, there's a whole page about this man, and you get to check out his Plus, he has his own website, of course, and I want to say, also another little plug, that Anand sings with his wife. They have a CD out. It's really, really beautiful. What's it called again?
It's called The Road, the Wheels, and the Rock.
If you want luscious music, I mean, to just kind of make yourself feel really good, I want to get that on iTunes or wherever.
It currently only exists as a virtual thing.
Well, the more you buy it, the more it'll become a reality that you can hold in your hand.
Yeah, bring it back. Bring it back.
This is a song that, when I heard it, I thought,
wow, that's a really old song. And then
I realized that actually no, it had just been written, and not too long ago. It's I learned it from the Whalen Jennies. It's their fabulous singer, Ruth Moody, sings with them. She writes songs that sound like they've been around forever. And I took it and just sort of straightened out the chorus a little bit so that everybody can sing along on it. Because whenever you hear a song and then the chorus, all it is like hallelujah. I mean, everybody, you just want to sing it. How's everybody doing?
Thank you. Thank you.
next tune is also on my CD, and I wasn't going to do it tonight. Anna said, hey, do that song. So this is The Night They Drove Old Dixie Down.
Never knew I had such a power.
Thank you.
sort of your classic old love song from the mountains kind of song, Handsome Molly.
One, two, three.
Come sing me a song.
basically, the idea was I was going to take my favorite songs from Rise Up Singing and put them on a CD. I'm going to sit again. And anyway, I couldn't figure out. I had a lot of favorites. Peter and I put Rise Up Singing together back in 1988. And our oldest son was, I think, around 2. And he's 26 now, so I don't know if that makes sense when we were working on this. He was a little 2-year-old. And we didn't have computers back then. Well, we had DOS. I guess that counts.
But she said we didn't have computers.
What was so great about that was we had to rely on each other, and we would have meetings with great friends and people that did a lot of singing. And we'd invite them to come from, you know, pretty much around the country to our house, and we'd sit down and have these little, well, what songs should be in a songbook kind of meetings. And I have no recollection of why we put this one in, but I absolutely love it. It's a Joan Baez song, and it's not that well known. And when we tried to find the copyrights for it for the CD, actually we had a really hard time. Turns out it's in Spanish. The copyright for the song is in Spanish. It's just beautiful. I really want to learn it in Spanish. I don't know what they mean in that language yet. But at any rate, all the weary mothers.
Instructor and the sun.
summer gathering of Quakers. We've got a bunch of friends here in the audience tonight. Eric Fowler and his lovely wife, Laura Duncan, sang this next song after they heard it on my CD. She said, I can't get it out of my head. And then I went to hear them sing, and they performed it. And she said, this next song is about grieving. And I had actually, I'd known that, but I'd never really kind of verbalized it. And so we're going to do a little Red Rockin' Chair for you. It's a song from the Appalachian Mountains. It's been done many different ways. And lots of bluegrass bands, you know, all these different kinds of styles do this song. And I've been playing it for a long time. I first got my first banjo when I was, I think I was 18, and it was sitting under a Christmas tree. I kind of saw it. My mom had gone to a local pawn shop and gotten a $10 banjo for me. So I've just been playing it a couple years, because that was just a couple years ago.
Yeah.
Actually, I remember my banjo teacher when I was in college, Susan Powers, was in a square dance band, and I would go and hear them, and loved hearing the frailing style, and I had been teaching myself bluegrass, which is a very different kind of thing. And I asked her if she'd give me lessons, and we were all out, it was just in Pittsburgh, and we were all students and kind of not a lot of money, kind of starving. She said, well, if you feed me soup, I'll come to your apartment and I'll teach you. So I think it was just a couple dollars and some soup. Your microphone limited here. We were talking earlier tonight. We've just seen Abigail Washburn in New York City in Central Park with playing some of her. She's an amazing banjo player. Some people know about her, some folks don't. She went up on stage and she said, I'd like to introduce my husband, Balin Slug. We're sitting out there.
This is a banjo player from one
so
time.
Great. Well, they call him the king and queen of the banjo now.
Big question, what did Balin Slug major in college? They wouldn't let him major in banjo.
What?
Physics?
No, it was a musical instrument.
Cello.
French horn.
French horn?
Oh, French horn player. Alright, now we're all set.
Thank you.
There was several years ago, there was a mass sort of shooting in the D.C. area. I don't remember that, but it was really scary and hard. And my sister's daughter, she and her daughter lived in the Bethesda area. And she was much younger than she is now. She's in college now. She was much younger. And, you know, these shootings were happening where they went shopping, where they got their gas. And a lot of the kids in the elementary schools and all were very scared. They couldn't sleep at night. So I wrote this song, and basically I didn't write the melody. I took an old Gaelic song that I had heard, Bach, Muir Trickett trio, Gordon Bach and Muir and Trickett, sang a song called Fir Abacha. It's a Gaelic tune, and I took that melody and I wrote some new words to it. So I was trying to find a lullaby type feel to it. Anyways, it's called Safe from Harm.
Thank you.
class on.
Are you getting ready to leave home too?
So we thought we'd end the evening with a little sing-along here, get everybody up and you guys join in on it.
Once again, I want to thank Paul Newlin tonight for all the organization that we've been talking about. Thank you also to Claudia for inviting us in your home and giving us some yummy hummus. A special thank you again, Mark Fraser on cello.